Hopefully that's a good face. What is up, guys? It's We Hate Ron here, and I'm back. And this week, I'm gonna give y'all another double upload week. So make sure to subscribe if you're not, to be notified when the second video for this week comes out. All right, so back when I made the 50 Facts video, I talked about how I only been jealous over a girl one time, and I said I was gonna give y'all a story time about that. And this is that story time, the jealousy story, man. Looking back on it, it was probably one of like those, it's funny to look back on it, but you know, going through it was probably like, oh, probably hell. Let's get this story started, man. This story is like the summer of fifth grade, all right? I used to go to the Boys and Girls Club, and I used to go there, I was going there since like I started like elementary school, so I've been there for a long ass time. And it was this one girl that always went there during the summer. She never went there during the school year, but it was always during the summertime. And I remember I always had a crush on this one girl, right? Her name is gonna be D, right? Because the beginning of her name begins with a D. D, she was always taller than me. See, like in middle school, I was short. So like D was probably here. I was probably like right there to D, right? She was dark skinned. She was real taller than me. Also, she was real slim. You already know. So the beginning of the summer camp, I remember getting there, and there's like when you walk in the Boys and Girls Club for the summer camp, usually like they're everybody like one spot, like we're separated by age groups. So, and there's like six rooms. There was the gym, the art room, the computer lab, the game room, then there was a secondary computer lab, and then there was the teen center. That day we were in the secondary computer lab, and when I walked in, I saw my nigga O. We're gonna call him O. And I sat behind him, and we were just catching up on like what we've been doing the school year and shit, right? Then all of a sudden, D walks into the room. When I mean my heart dropped, I mean like my heart dropped. Like I was like, dang. And then, mind you, this is like going into middle school, so that's when everybody started hitting puberty. And I don't think I need to go into detail on what, you know what I'm saying? Why that's important. But yeah, E looked even better than she usually looked. And I was just like, in my head, I'm like, all right, this summer, I'm gonna have to talk to her. But I can't just go like, I went like so many summers without talking to her. I'm not gonna let this summer be the last summer, you know? And I just, you know, it was a fail. What I'm happening, she walks in, you know, she signs in, and then she comes and sits right behind me. Oh, like she gets a chair and she puts it behind us and pops a squat right behind us. Now I'm already nervous and shit, right? And we've never talked, so it would be weird for me to say, hey, what's up? So I was just continuing to play on the computer, being a little bitch. I am. What ended up happening was she kind of looks at me, but she doesn't, I guess, like she kind of looks at me, but she doesn't know who I am. He leans over to O, and they're starting to whisper, and me, you know, I was kind of, since they were like right beside me, I was kind of listening to what they were saying. But D was just like, so who was he, you know what I'm saying? And then O was like, yeah, that's Aaron. And then she asked him like, when did I get the braids and stuff? And you know, they were just having this little like conversation. And I think, so then after they got done with their little, you know, like secret conversation about me, we all started to talk, and we all started like rotating in the computer because we was all playing a game. And I think that was the day me and D got cool. The first few weeks, me, O, D, and then we had two other people, which was C, my nigga C, and one of her friends, T. You know what I'm saying? We're just using the first letter of their names. So we all became this one group, a group of like five. And we were, everywhere we went, we were all together, right? O and C knew that I had a thing for D. So every time me and D were alone, you know, O and C wouldn't, you know, go and bother us because they knew. Summer was 3 months. So the first 2 months, me and D were always together, you know. Like we would always do stuff. We always be in the line together. We play a game, we sit in the line together. You know what I'm saying? Like we be in the gym, we always be right next to each other. Like It was lit. Laugh at my jokes. She always smile at me. She always, bro, she gave me the best hugs. I do remember that. Like, she always gave me the best hugs. One thing that happened that I will always remember this. All right, so every Friday, we would go, like, we were like, I think we were 10 and 11. So we would go into the teen center and watch movies. So there were two couches. There was a couch with three seats, and then there was a love seat. So we would always get the couch with three seats, and D would always save me. She was sitting horizontal to the seat, so like nobody could get the seat beside her. Dude walking in front of me, and when I was, she looked at me and she like waved her hand to come on, right? So I was walking and dude was still walking in front of me, and all of a sudden, right, this nigga in front of me is gonna push her to the side and sit in the seat that she saved for me. When I mean she was mad that it happened, like she was like livid. Like she started yelling at the dude, like telling him to get up. And then, you know, I was just kind of sitting there like, dang, she really wanted me to sit with her and shit like that. And then she ended up just getting up and sitting. She like grabbed my wrist, ended up just like, we just sat on the floor and watched the movie. Like, at that point, I had no doubt in my head that she was feeling the kid. Like, I just knew she liked me. So everything was going good. But there's always the fucked up part of the story. This was the last month of summer camp, right? It was the morning time. And we're all just doing, the five of us is doing what we had to do, right? And then we see this new kid, this light-skinned dude, just chilling by himself. Like, now, none of us have seen this dude ever. Like, we don't know who this guy is. Like, he just came in and sat down. So me being, you know, the nice person, I went over there and I was like being friendly towards dude. And I was like, yo, what's up? What's your name? He's like, oh yeah, my name's B. I'm like, oh, what's up? So then, you know, I let him join the clique. I integrate him into the circle. Five of us became six. So I let him in the group to be cool with it. Thing I should have never did. As we became cool, you know, we made sure that he was always with us. So he started hanging with D more. You know, and I kind of noticed it that, you know, when we would be all in a group, he would always be near her. And I was kind of just like, yeah, dude, hell is you doing? This is the shit that was kind of just so fucked up. So this nigga came up to me, right? To me. He gonna straight up tell my face. He's like,
so, do you think D would date me?
Nigga!
You understand how bad I want to hit that man in his shit. Like, I really want to just deck that man, because I'm just like, really, dude? But you know, I gave him the benefit of the doubt because he didn't really know. But you know, me being me, I just kind of shifted him towards, you know, maybe you should, you know, look for somebody else, my G. Like, maybe not her, you feel me? They started hanging out more. And the more and more, you know, he was hanging out with her, the less and less she was hanging out with me. And this, if y'all could tell, it was a problem. And it got to the point where, you know, she was like giving this man his full attention. And I'm just sitting out on the outskirts, kind of just, you know, sad and in my shits. Cause you know, she was like the main one I really fucked with, you feel me? But then one day, they had a field trip, and they were going to this little pool shit. And, you know, I can't swim, so I wasn't going to waste, like, $15 on a field trip that I wasn't even going to enjoy. So what I ended up doing, I ended up staying. And D ended up, you know, I guess she forgot her money, so she was crying that day. You know, me being, you know, me being the dude I am, I went over there and comforted her. I was like, oh, so why are you crying? Why are you upset? And she told me that, you know, she ain't had no money. I mean, she didn't have the money, and, you know, she really wanted to go. But I was just like, yo, you just chill with me. Whole day, me and D was just chilling. Like, it was awesome. Like, because, you know, everybody was gone. So we had the whole game room to ourselves. We was playing the game. Like I said, we was playing the Wii. We was playing Xbox. We was playing ping pong, pool. Like, It was lit, cause we was only two there, and like we had no line to wait in. It was all like fine and dandy, but then like Nah, his name not B anymore. I call him Lightbright. So then Lightbright came back and shit went hit the fan again. Now this is the last field trip that we went on. I had to go to the last field trip. I wasn't just gonna sit this one out because we went back to this pool and I wasn't just gonna like sit out because I ain't swim, so I was there. B, Lightbright, bitch nigga, whatever you wanna call him, he was off doing some other shit, right? And me, D, and O were all, I had a life jacket on so I could get in the fucking pool and do shit. So we were playing, what is that game called? Somebody would go under the water and they would just, dunking. Oh yeah, you would get dunked. So they would go under the water and grab your legs and come up and bam you in the water and shit. So when we got back on the bus, my sister was there too. All right, us and then the older kids were there too. So my sister was able to be in the bus with us. My sister knew I was in love with this girl, right? So my sister looks at me and she kind of just said, come here. So I come over, and she asked me, do you want me to tell D that, I'm feeling her? I'm just all right, fuck it. Since it's the last day of camp, you might as fucking well. My sister leans over and calls D over. So she leans over to my sister and, my sister tells her that, my little brother's in love with you. Facial expression she made was kind of, I don't know if I could say it was good or was it bad. She kind of looked at me and was just like, we didn't talk. I mean, it was kind of like little conversation back to the, to the place and shit. And after that, never seen her again. So really, she's the one that got away. 2 months later though, I ended up forgiving bitch nigga about, taking my girl and shit. So we were texting one night and I asked him, are you still in contact with Dean? He said, yeah. And then I asked him, hey, give me her number. This nigga gonna straight up tell me no. Who the fuck that nigga is? All right, y'all. That was my jealousy story. If y'all like that at any point, subscribe, because it is a double upload week and I will be uploading another video. And y'all need to know when that video is gonna drop. Also, follow me on my Instagram, because a lot of people with YouTube channels have been following me on Instagram and I want to know if most of them came from my channel. So if y'all have, tell me that y'all came from my channel and follow me on my Instagram, because I will check out y'all channels and I will subscribe. All right, so it's We Hate Ron and I'm out, man.